welcome to this very important conference, okay, organised by BADACA, Bristol District and Anti-Tax Alliance. My name is Lisa Umperin. I'm a teacher. I'm part of the NUT.
Our members have been told for years the reason we have low pay is because of the total reward package we get, about flexible working, family-friendly policies, and pension we get, and job security. Well, all of those things are under attack, so we have no option but to fight.
In the health service, we want real industrial action, none of this working to rule, building up towards and making things more difficult management. It must be, we need to declare war on this government, and that means a ballot for industrial action.
I think obviously the government counter-offensive is really beginning now. We had a CBI boss on the TV yesterday saying we needed to tighten our belts and we should pay for the boss's crisis.
Friends and comrades and friends, I stand before you in the words of Trevor Kavanagh of The Sun, a strutting union boss, my only concern, my own political ambition. Well, I'm bad to say that I think that a 92% yes vote on a turnout of 40% might entitle me to strut just a little bit with pride at the tremendous campaign that NUT members have been waging since the autumn and even before the autumn in defence of teachers' pensions and the public sector across the board.
What we're facing in this country is a government-instigated hate campaign, not just against those on benefits, but against public sector workers in general. And that is a cover for what would be, what is really going on, the biggest transfer of wealth and power from ordinary people to that tiny elite in society who put profit before people.
We're also glossing over the fact that 1.4 million pensioners already live in poverty without these cuts to the pensions.
I think it's clear for Unison, I think it's clear for all the health unions, pensions will be, for us, a decisive battle, and it'll also be a decisive battle for the government and their ruling class.
That we're the ones defending pensions. It's not about taking pensions, taking money out of the private sector workers. We want to lift everybody up.
We won't accept any cuts to our services. We don't just want more of the same. We want something different. And not only conquering this government town.
We want people to come down on the picket lines and show support if you're not on strike on that day. Obviously, if you are, then please have a picket line in your workplace.
And I think the anti-cuts has a vital role in terms of coordination, support and action, supporting occupations, organising demonstrations and supporting health workers in terms of industrial action.
We have to be in our trades councils. We have to be active in our trade unions and in any kind of community organising. We have to demonstrate together and where we can, we have to take industrial action.
But we are moving into a new phase. I mean, the strike that is taking place on the 30th of June is clearly not a pantomime, a dress rehearsal for anything. It's a real dispute. It's real class war between a government that is determined to drive down the living conditions and the retirement conditions of public sector workers and a workforce that has had enough and is not prepared to accept that.
Everybody in this room, to go out as you are, I guess, and be a leader in your workplace and community in order to put the alternative to the barbarism of this government and the barbarism of this society. And secondly, everybody, whether you're a PCS or education member, a union member or not, is to build for the 30th of June. It's a strike not just for our workplaces, it's a strike for our communities as well. So let's turn it into a festival of resistance and let's make sure that we stick together, and if we do, we can defeat these people. Thank you.
Yeah.